San Francisco in the middle 60s was a very special time and place to be a part of. But no explanation, no mix of words or music or memories can touch that sense of knowing that you were there and alive in that corner of time and the world. Whatever it meant.
The cross was a mushroom. And the mushroom was also the tree of good and evil. The philosophical stone of the alchemists was LSD.
Clearly, I was a victim of the drug explosion. A natural street freak, just eating whatever came by.
He's lying to us. Seeing the eyes.
This is not a good town for psychedelic drugs. Extremely menacing vibrations were all around us.
Newspaper man came up and he said, have you had LSD? So I thought,
I see.
Well, I'll either be cagey or I'll be honest. So I said, yes.
Did you eat all this acid?
That's right. Music!
For trouble.
Somebody gave me this telephone. And she said, I could talk to God with it, but I don't have anything to say.
We had 2 bags of grass, 75 pellets of mescaline, 5 sheets of high-powered blotter acid, a salt shaker half full of cocaine,
some wood,
a whole galaxy of multicolored uppers, downers, screamers, laughers, also a quart of tequila, quart of rum, case of beer, pint of raw ether, 2 dozen amulets. Not that we needed all that for the trip, but once you get locked into a serious drug collection, the tendency is to push it as far as you can.
I don't want to go
among
mad people.
Oh, you can't help that. Most everyone is mad.
Will you throw this thing into the tub when White Rabbit peaks?
Yeah, that last tub of acid I was saving.
Yeah, this could be the right place.
I dropped it.
Dropped acid?
Mother
of God. There I am. Holy fuck.
One of the things you learn after years of dealing with drug people is that you can turn your back on a person, but never turn your back on a drug.
I need this, right?
I remember your face.
There is no way of explaining the terror I felt.
The basic theory of the acid, why do people take drugs of any sort, from alcohol to acidos to hard drugs? And that question has to be resolved first before you think, well, what can we do to a poor drug addict? Why do we and you and anybody have to have these accessories to normal living?
Panic. It crept up my spine like first rising vibes of an acid frenzy.
I mean, is there something wrong with society that's making us so pressurized that we cannot live in it without guarding ourselves against it?
Ignore the nightmare in the bathroom. You're just another ugly refugee from the love generation.
I think if people are allowed to be a bit more free and express themselves, they wouldn't have to inhibit themselves by taking drugs to not be heard. People take drugs and drink because they don't feel what's going on around them.
What was I doing out here? What was the meaning of this trip? Was I just roaming around in a drug frenzy of some kind? Or had I really come out here to Las Vegas to work on a story?
You know, Billy, we blew it.
One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small. And the one that mother gives you don't do anything at all. So ask Alice.
You took too much, man. You took too much, too much.
What could a rabbit possibly be meant for?
And if you go
Mr. Rabbit?
Chasing rabbits.
Wait!
And you know you're going to fall. Tell about the smoke that a killer has given you the call.
voice was screaming, "Holy Jesus, where are these goddamn animals?"
Don't you fucking
back there.